better watch APAC Premiere.
Oh, all right, fair enough. Normally I get a head-to-head of the player cam, so I usually know when to shut up, but that's fine. We're going to jump in pretty quickly. No worries at all. So no Bastion to start things off here, Jason, though we do have the Genji Tracer combos from both sides here. And so far, XQ looking pretty good. Finds 11-5-20 early on.
Yeah, so we do actually have the Tracer Genji combo coming for Zetner. Most importantly, this is what we didn't see up against AF Blue, which is a little bit concerning why we didn't see it then. Maybe they didn't feel like up to playing at that kind of standard of RM. And we cry. But in the meantime, they've been able to take the point in the first go. So credit to them to be able to pull this one off.
Yeah, I mean, good opening there. They pick up one of the supports from Morstrike at the start of the fight, and then they clean up Lucio towards the end there. So good opening. I've said about Samsara's Genji. I don't know. He played on Eichenwald. It was the only time he played it against SKG, and it wasn't able to do much. That's the thing. I didn't really have to do much either, because SKG kind of played themselves. But anyway, let's jump in this one now. We'll talk about it later, perhaps, if it's relevant. Samsara forced to back away there. Pulse Bomb comes down. That's a nice pick off there. Siorin goes down, and this is good for Allstrike. Very good. Samsara gets himself two kills. It's starting to snoop to fall there. Gets yet another one. Delay falls down. I just look like an idiot when I say
this. I know.
These
that's
things.
Exactly what I was thinking. No, like, weren't we okay. just talking about Samsara
yeah,
not being
okay.
that good on Genji?
He picks it on Eichenwald, and it wasn't Samsara that won the game, is my point. Like, it was like. SKG tried to play a Mercy on that map, and they just didn't really make it work that well. Samsara was okay. I just didn't think it was impactful as his Reaper often was, sorry. But he did fine there. He did okay. I'll give that to him.
Oh, that's going to be a great kill out of 11-5-20. Able to pick
yes,
up the initial.
Right. Sorry, carry on.
Okay, so actually able to get one kill, get some decent damage onto Lucio, and a good reflect on the rain as well. Takes him down below half HP, and the pressure's coming from both directions. He's going to finish him off with the dash. And the Lucio, that's going to be a free kill for him. Even the Zarya Shield's not going to be enough to save him, most likely. Next Q is eventually going to finish off Yongbon. And then they're going to continue to hold.
So you can watch how XQ plays there as well. He saw Rain coming towards him, low health, and he always wants to finish off with the dash there as well. But he knows he's going to have another one available. It lets him still stay mobile and not sort of be picked off there. So Dene come back in towards to take control with this one. This is good to see from them now. They're navigating this matchup reasonably well, in my opinion. No changes yet from really either side here, but what's important is 9139 does have the Graviton Surge here to start things off. And Samsara with the Dragon Plate, that's pretty big. We might not even see that. Oh, we do. We see that come out here from Samsara. I don't know if it really connects, because XQ actually takes down East. No kills come off that Graviton Surge there, because obviously Yamato managed to get himself on with the Transcendence, and now he's going to come back in response. Detonator used the Graviton Surge a little bit more effectively, and Yamato gets two kills over it.
Yeah, you saw XQ when that fight broke out. He actually dashed in towards the point and put Reflect up immediately, hoping he was going to catch out the Graviton Surge Reflect in. Obviously, it didn't work out, but the backup wasn't there, and they might have just overextended a little bit too far. Rain down to 30 HP. He's going to have to pick up the health pack and back away. We'll find out. I think this is one of the first games here, Mitch. We're not actually seeing Anna ever played.
Yeah, no, but not touchy. I mean, King of the Hill, maybe there's more of an argument to be made for leaving her out in some cases here, especially if you want to play a comp like this. But Pulse Bomb in, no one really there to stick it. You got to stick it on people, Rain. It definitely helps things out there on towards the point. But still, Stylish New didn't really look at him now, and that's an easy pick up on towards Yamato. Very much not being focused down now, especially because East is causing so much trouble there. Three kills for the Winston for Allstrike during that fight, and that leaves Rain with so much freedom to work around the side. He eventually falls, but this point gets flipped back. Not a moment too soon either. Detonator, one more one fight, and they're going to have this.
He was trying to go for the hell pack, hit 11 HP, and that's going to cost him a... Well, it's cost his team a little bit of extra time.
Cost him a few seconds.
Some percent. Yeah, he's going to build some percent here. Allows Rain to get in position with the Pulse Bomb. No Graviton to pair up with just yet, as you can see. 9139 only at about 60% to go. But they have the Transcendence for Detonator, so they have the ability to push him. Problem is, if you use it now, you won't have it for the Graviton Surge Pulse Bomb combo later on, or at least the Graviton Surge in general. But luckily for the Pulse Bomb doesn't really do much.
No, it really doesn't connect there. I mean, Delay's going to have one for himself in just a second here. Siorin opens up, though. 9139 goes down. No chance to build up the Graviton Surge in this fight. It could have potentially had a Delay, though, has his ultimate. Samsara gets course walking across the front of him there. Caught out by the Pulse Pistols of Delay now as well. The freedom you can make... the freedom you can get as a Tracer in these positions can really pay dividends now. Delay holds that Pulse Bomb. Samsara comes in maybe unnecessarily here for Detonator, but I guess they want to make sure they take this point now. They get a full wipe. They're going to win the round off the back of this one. Rain gets shielded in, but not really willing to go towards the point. The shield expires. He drops, and that's going to be Detonator taking the first round.
Wow, okay. So, Detonator had to be happy about that one. You can see him even high-five each other. It'll take their first point in the series, potentially the first map in the entirety of the tournament so far. They still have a lot of work ahead of them here as Allstrike Gaming, towards the end, I think, of that round. In the beginning and the end, started to show some good signs of life.
Well, you're fighting for survival right now if you're a Detonator. I mean, you pick this map. This must be their best. I mean, it must be one of the best left for them in the draft process here. So, yeah, Allstrike looking a little bit flaccid on this map. A little bit flimsy, I have to say. I'm not really sure about that one at all. I mean, they have a very similar comp coming in as Detonator there. I mean, I don't blame Samsara really for anything. I said his Genji wasn't impressive. It doesn't mean he's a bad Genji. But now it goes towards the Reaper here. Obviously, this is a map that facilitates much more for that Reaper getting in, sneaking in behind and from underneath.
Yeah, Ciaran's going to have a tough time if he jumps in towards the back, which they have kind of depend on for the most part. He's going to have a really interesting surprise for him in the meantime. But yeah, Reaper, definitely a lot better on this map. A lot more different angles you can come from, a lot more different paths you can flank around with, a lot more freedom in general for him. But he just hasn't had the opportunity to really make anything happen. I wonder if he's trying to sit on his supports for the most part, expecting Ciaran to jump in on top.
Well, it's a good idea. I think that's what actually was something we said.
Yeah, he's actually still there.
That's something we said that he should do actually in the game against NGA and didn't really do. So now, good position. Ciaran going to be very, very careful. The bubble actually, he's just stepping in and out of that one, able to keep himself alive. And Samsara does manage to back away and get the health back. That's important. He can now come back to the fight, pick up Ciaran there. Is the XQ making it life a little bit difficult here? And Samsara's being harassed on multiple sides. Pulse Bomb pretty much got stuck to him there. There's no way of getting away from that one. XQ and the rest of Detonator now just have to go back and focus on towards the point. Dragon Blade comes out. The boot was a little bit early, in my opinion, coming out there from 11-5-20, but still, I'm going to keep himself alive long enough. And XQ taken down by Rain, who now is starting to make it happen.
Yo, the pulse one, that one's going to stick this time. But Zarshield's going to come in and actually save his life for now. They're forced to back away. Rain's on 4 HP. He cannot go in as he's finally being healed up by his teammates. And the nano boost, we're finally seeing Anna being picked up here by Youngbot. Just looking for a target to put him on. Most likely going to be going to Samsara, but with Detonator being held back towards the spawn, no real need to use it just yet until they engage.
It's good aggression coming out here from Allstrike, really pushing Detonator back, and off the back of a Rain on that Tracer as well is causing a lot of problems here. They actually managed to catch out this Anna. Should be a kill. Kid slept cheaply enough. It's going to be Youngbarn's gift from the grave, but still, X2 going to be able to pick himself up on his feet and get back going again. Quick little flank here. That was a very, I guess, hard to spot movement from XQ, but he just works his way around the pillar and goes in and gets a very early kill on towards Samsara. Now he might have to back away a little bit because a lot of focus for Allstrike is on this part of the map. They've got 5 ultimates to play with when the fight really gets heavy on the point.
Yeah, and even if they want to use them, if they can stagnate them out enough, they could be looking at 90% advantage before Detonator even has a chance to capitalize on the point. But the Graviton Surge is up for Stylish Noob. He's not really been able to play Reaper, or Reinhardt, sorry. Remember, he was the key player for Detonator at the top of the show, but so far just hasn't had an opportunity to excel. But if he gravitons with the Dragon Blade out of XQ, this could be huge.
Yeah, XQ actually isn't going on towards the Graviton to the targets. He's actually trying to deal with Youngbarn, but good timing with the Sound Barrier. A lot of defensive ults being drawn out of Allstrike here, but if it works in this fight, it's definitely worthwhile. Still, Yamato actually gets himself one, and Delave's still alive here. So between the Tracer and Zenyatta, there's a lot of problems being caused by Detonator. That means that, well, it's going to have to be Rain to stand tall and make it happen. He's going to back away yet again, and now with two players able to pressure on towards Ciaran, he's going to have to jump away. Clutch Shield to keep him alive. He should be able to get a health pack and stay healthy for the moment. But Allstrike have held this point for the entire round, and it doesn't look like it's going to change anytime soon. They will try and contest it.
Now they're going to try to contest it, but the Winston being nano boosted, and he's going to be able to do so much damage. However, the pulse bombs are going to come through out of Rain. The shield, yeah, came in, mitigated most of that damage. But East finally able to chime in. He does have that primary edge available, and he could potentially knock quite a few people off at this point. That pulse bomb coming in out of delay is not really going to catch on anything, actually. And XQ's able to finally come in and clean things up, but East is still alive, and he's picked himself up another double.
Yeah, and that was really important as well. Delay was very low after his duel with Rain, and although Rain struggled to track and actually got killed in the end, XQ now is going to have the same problem here, trying to back away from the Winstons. Tough to block lightning here, and yeah, going to have to get back. Yombar pits him up with one more dart here. Overtime's being triggered, but now that should be it. It does time out, and one apiece here. Allstrike, very appropriate response on that map, and again, the jovialness, I say jovialness, I don't know if that's a word of this team, shining through. Confidence now for Allstrike, a weak star for showing up and showing us that they can play on these King of the Hill maps.
Yeah, and Samsara did a relatively good job on that Reaper. I had to kind of question the ult use coming out of Detonator, because they had a Graviton Surge on a Stylish Noob to pair in with the Dragon Blade, but he didn't use it. He actually died before he got it off, and yeah. XQ popped his Dragon Blade, maybe expected it to be thrown down, and then he goes to focus the Anna, the Zenyatta gets Transcendence off, and it's like, all right, well, now you can't really win this fight.
Yeah, it's not even XQ's fault there. I mean, he wanted to kill Youngbarn, which is fine. I mean, before the Sound Barrier and the Transcendence got used, it was a possibility, but the fact is that Allstrike had so many ults, they had 5 ults built up, and they're more than happy to invest 2 defensive ults when they're already 50% ahead, and they just held the point from there on out. So, Shrine, here we go. Our third map and the one that we haven't quite seen yet here. Detonator straight up very, very strong on Village. Now, this is maybe a little bit more similar, at least in its openness, but Samsara is going to be on the Reaper again here.
Yeah, so this is actually, again, a relatively good map. It depends on how you want to play Reaper. If you're going to sit on point where you have such close range battles, or be sneaky once you do capture the point. But for him, he kind of overextends, and the entirety of Detonator just turns around and cleans the floor with him. Drain's finally able to chime on the one kill back, but he's lost the majority of his team, and I don't really actually know if he's going to be able to turn this around. You can see 3 people, 4 people dancing around him, and he's just going to let himself die to respawn back in with a seal.
Yeah, I mean, at that point there as well, he would have loved an exit kill or just a way to delay a little bit longer and then just back away. I mean, he intended to go off the edge there, even though that's probably what Detonator wanted for him. So initial control going over to them. I think that just overwhelmed very, very briefly in that first little fight. I mean, the only big difference between the comps, they got the Ana, of course, All-Strike, and not the Zenyatta. So I prefer this. I prefer Ana Lucio over Ana Zenyatta, to be honest, especially with the Sound Barrier offering you protection against that Pulse Bomb, which often comes in. But Samsara moving on to the point yet again, he has to be aggressive. That's kind of his role here, and he needs to hope that there's going to be protection and there's going to be shields coming in from his team to allow him to do this sort of stuff. Dragon Blade comes out. He sees Samsara getting cut down to size. XQ eventually finds 115-20, and then Samsara falls down there. So. Yeah, and losing teammates, no one was there to keep that Reaper alive.
Yeah, he was able to pick up, was it two kills? He get like assist on a third and he escaped with about 10 HP, but eventually being finished off. Yeah, like you lose too many people, yeah, you kill two, but when you lose four in the process, obviously a trade that's not going to work out for you too well. Now going to the next attack, or at least looking for the setup here, Detonator. Have to worry about this high ground position. And he had the Nano Boost Death Blossom coming in momentarily. Because there's no Graviton Surge to facilitate this. They popped the Death Blossom already and the Nano Boost, but he hasn't been able to pick up a single kill.
Yeah, Transcendence covers over a lot of that there as well. Good response from Yamada when keeping his team alive. And actually, they finally start to lose some numbers here, but it's not because of Samsara. I mean, Stardust do falls and then the Rain takes down Sayori. So Samsara backed into a corner. Now Sound Barrier comes out. Graviton Surge. This should be a one fight for All-Strike. They've used so many ults to get it. And yeah, they're going to win this one out eventually. They flip it back, but with not much of an ult bank to sort of rely on and already giving 70% of it towards Detonator, they've left this a little bit later than they really should have.
Especially if you look at Silas, Noob, and Delay, and they have the Wombo combo ready to go. It's an All-Strike, you need to position themselves. I would love to see Samsara get aggressive, like teleport up towards the top right side, catch people off if they
come.
Yeah, exactly, come from that direction. You have your Wraithborn to escape. You have the ability to run back to your teammates without being picked off, and instead they're going to give up a lot of positions. They're going to allow Detonator to go for the attack. And so far, that Graviton Surge is working out for him.
Yeah, I mean, that's the pick-off. Graviton Surge does come in there, but it's not a heck of a lot to capitalize here. Delay does get the Pulse Bomb in. That's two kills. That's, or maybe the bare minimum that they probably should have wanted to get there. But Delay keeps himself scarce long enough to manage to pick up Samsara, who has to go for him now. And this is good. Didn't I have the ultimates here to really finish the job, I'd say. But Beast, good timing there as well. It's going to be East the Beast either way. Delay eventually going to be able to take him down now, and Detonator do flip it back. So, and they allow All-Strike to get a decent bank up here in the elongated fight, but All-Strike... Well, they're going to have to go for yet another probably Death Blossom combined with the Nana Boost here. But, you know, Yamato, again, he can respond quite comfortably with the Transcendence.
Well, that's if the Transcendence works, though. If the Bio Grenade comes in, which is what's so good about an Ana, pretty much mitigates that ultimate completely. But you can see them already pushing him straight back. The Death Blossom is going to be popped. He doesn't have speed to help him actually push into this one, but nonetheless, he still gets the two kills. And the rest of the team's going to be there to shut this one down. And we're still going to have this map continuing here as All-Strike's going to take the point back. Look for some percent to build back up.
Yeah, they need to, and they can actually solidify a little bit more here, actually. Sound Barrier is going to be available for 11-5-20 in a moment. That's going to be pretty handy. I mean, it's mostly defensive ults install that's sort of going to be available to All-Strike here, but then I don't have a lot to work with, really. No Dragon Blade to cut through, Pulse Bomb there, but Stardust Noob's still a long way away from having the Graviton Surge. So, Samsara parks himself in the corner here on the point. You can see Detonator again take the high ground and jump down. So the safest way to avoid poke while getting as close to the point as possible. They're actually going over towards the other side here. They isolate Yongbarn up. That's perfect now. XQ's going to have to deal with the Winston in just a moment here. He's able to back away there. His Beast or East is going to be able to get the Sound Barrier as the rest of his teammates do as well. Samsara finds Spike here. Now going to have to go in towards a Wraithborn. But look, he's found himself a target. Yamato Wen can't escape from that.
Yongbarn got such a bad position actually with him getting caught out. He got jumped onto by Sioran and East trying to jump in to help out, but it just wasn't enough because XQ was there on the Genji to turn things around. The Graviton Surge being able to come through is... Honestly, All-Strike are still holding on to this one somehow. They're still maintaining this one. Rain has just been able to sit on the point for the majority of this one, and not to mention all the kills trickling through for All-Strike. They're at 97%. Can Detonator even get back to the point to contest this?
I don't think so. They're going to chase down the vestiges of them now as well. Yamato can't get close enough, and this is big for All-Strike. They've turned it around. Nicely done. 2-1 there, and it was good use of those ultimates at the end. And XQ being shut down. He had that last Dragon Blade. He had to dash out of the Graviton Surge, then pull the blade out, then try and get back, but he sort of caught himself on a wall, and then all of his intended targets were shielded it up. That was his chance to break the mold there, but nice work by All-Strike. They were in a position where they had to win one fight when they had an ultimate disadvantage, and they managed to just sustain through it.
I'm honestly surprised that All-Strike was able to win that one. I was trying to point out that Yongbarn, he was on the high ground. He was trying to beat Ana, right? He was trying to appeal to her strengths, like sitting back, sitting far away, and getting so much healing off, but he got jumped onto by Winston and Genji. And when that happens, you're most likely going to die. So we saw East try to jump the back lines to help him, actually jump into his own back lines to help him, so he couldn't actually deal with the front line that was coming at him. And eventually, I mean, it didn't really matter because they won the map, but that actually could have gone a lot worse. That could have been Detonator's 2-1 lead.
Yeah, I mean, it was smart, but Detonator actually go to Pyongban there. East responded, though. That's what's most important for all Strikes. They had the peel for the Ana. Even though she died, they managed to make it a trade at the very least here. Good opening, though, again from Detonator on this map. They won this one on the first occasion here. And yeah, they're going to be able to clean up fairly comfortably here. The brawl out is working in their favor quite heavily. Rain's going to be cut down. Eventually, a Tracer can run rampant, but she's always focused down towards the end there, especially when she lacks teammates. Execute. Fancies or thinks again about trying to take down Yongban, and Detonator will have control early on. Again, it's going to be the Ana and the Ruby combo here. So Samsara not playing Genji on this stage of Village as he did in the first round.
Yeah, so I think he's feeling a little bit more confidence, Reaper. Maybe he wants to go back to this hero where not feeling as comfortable on his Genji. That dash out of XQ just catches four people, and the right clicks alone as well, able to help him build up to 88, now 90% on his ultimate. He's going to have his Dragon Blade for the next fight, and with the way this fight's already been going, Detonator's going to hold strong again.
Really nice by Delave there as well. I mean, he's picking up both the tanks in that fight, and then onto his Lucio one. 11-5-20 is going to fall there. So really nice work. The Tracer, they're causing a lot of problems here in AllStrike. Maybe they'll address that one. I mean, they don't have anything that really beats a Tracer out on AllStrike. I mean, the Reaper, not really. Yeah, no Roadhog, no McCree. So if they allow, you know, Delay to cause them too many problems, they're going to struggle to respond. They need to hope the rain does in one better.
They've actually given up position around the point here, so trying to go back at this. Pulse Bomb's going to come in huge where they're all clumped together. You can see the Reaper off to the left-hand side. Pulse Bomb's going to come through. Samsara's going to fall. And Delay is just not being touched, as you pointed out before. There's no one to do it so far in this round. And so far in this fight, they have no answer for him.
And ordinarily, that's not a problem because AllStrike have the Tracer as well, but Rain's getting cut down and not really able to do as much as he should. Now he's striving in this fight. He manages to get on towards Yamato in, and there is going to be East. Again, you can just see that Rain getting so many Pulse Bombs available to him there, just able to set up fights.
He missed that Pulse Bomb, though. He actually hit the shield with it. He threw it on the shield, so it actually didn't connect on any damage.
But cheap for him to get, right? They don't need this one. It's not like he has to wait long for his next one.
And it's not like they lost the fight. They actually had the fight one anyways, so it's not a big deal. But yeah, this man, he's been charging up relatively quickly, and Detonator, they need to get this point back. They're currently down 2-1. If they lose this point, they lose this map. And Rain coming in from behind. You're not going to miss shots like that on the Yamatan, who's just not even looking at you. There's no protection for him. That's just a mistake in a Detonator to not watch all their angles and just to be taken from behind.
Rain there as well. Now, this time actually being left alive here. So AllStrike, to be fair, I mean, they were a long way behind. You can see how snowbally this map can be, or in fact, a lot of King of the Hill maps after winning that first fight. 62% for Detonator. So AllStrike have to win two consecutive fights, and this often means that one of those fights is at an alt disadvantage if you use them all to get initial control in the first place. Again, here, they don't really have anything to work with, whereas Stylish Sheep does have the Graviton Surge to lay down. They're going to have a little bit to work with, so we'll see how it works out. XQ, though, wants to go for Yongbin, or at least just force him away, but he needs to respond. The Graviton Surge laying down, he needs to at least add his damage to the pile and hope it's going to be enough. He didn't need to retake this point now, otherwise this gets out of their control. The Dragon Blade coming in is quite timely, but XQ lacks teammates as East and Samsara have been cutting them down. And now Rain can just move off of the point now. Might just be the high ground positioning for AllStrike. That's three fights, one in a row for AllStrike now. That's good because they build up enough ult in that one to no longer be at a disadvantage in that regard, and they're ahead.
The most important part of that fight is that they survived a Graviton Surge without a Transcendence. Without a Transcendence, that typically doesn't happen. And they didn't even use a Sabre. They had no defensive ultimates, and yet they still were able to win that fight. But here we go. It's going to potentially one of the last fights of this map.
Did he reflect that Graviton Surge? I'm not quite sure. He might have actually done that. Regardless, no, it looks like it actually went over him. So he reflected something. I saw it fly over the top of him. We get too excited about these things sometimes. Pulse Bomb comes down, though, but Samsara gets himself two quick kills. Now Rain has a deal with the Sound Barrier side of Detonator. There are a lot of very tanky targets, and a Tracer doesn't do that all that much damage. It takes time. It's more damage over time. It's not burst. But still, Rain is still alive, and that is a big part of AllStrike's plan. Now, they can win this one out right here and now. Detonator are going to get knocked out of the competition. They can't get back on towards this point. They must control. It's sink or swim right now for the Japanese squad. It looks like no. It's a rock tied to their feet, straight to the bottom, and AllStrike take away. It's a 2-0 win for the Chinese side, and they will advance and have a shot, at least, at the wildcards.
Wow, that's really unfortunate. Both